Alright, we got two tiers. Let's grab the two Ziggs to start off this game, and Kled. Looks like maybe I'm gonna play something weird. Double tier. What else do we get? We got Monai. Let's grab the Kha'Zix. Welcome back, everybody, to another match. We got Hecarim Bane. Sure, let's put Hecarim and Bane. Two star Kled, Ziggs, and Hecarim. I think this might be the play. Let's sell the Kha'Zix, Kalista, level up to 4. Get the Vayne in as well. We got 2 Furion, 2 Cavalier, and Hellions. Hey, you know what? Let's go blue buff. I don't remember the last time I built this item, but it's been a long time. So let's try blue buff this game. I don't know what's gonna happen, but let's pick up the Leona. From these items, let's get a Chain Vest. Hecarim, Sejuani. Alright, that's cool. Is this the Brandon Hecarim carry game? Hey, you know what? That is a possibility. That comp has really fallen off in this recent meta, but that is a real possibility. That is a real possibility here. We got a Chain Vest and a bow. Let's take a... The Hecarim has a tier, huh? Now let's grab a large rod. Not feeling a tier on a Hecarim. Frozen Heart kind of sucks. Okay. Fine, let's 2-star Sedge, level up. I didn't want to give her a large rod, but you know what? Just want to win as much as possible here, so we will take the Sedge too. Gwinsu Vayne, yes, that's an option, but I don't actually plan to make Vayne or use Gwinsu as a carry item this game, so we're not going to go for Gwinsu. Most likely not. I got some kind of Hecarim thing or Cavalier thing going on this game. So let's see what else shows up in this game. And then we will go from there. Alright. We'll go from there. Alright. We got Ash. We can drop the Ash, I think. Sell the Ash here. Yeah, let's Econ. Get the Nautilus off our board. Let's build a Bramble Vest for our guy Hecarim in the front. For some more tankiness, we still have a 1-star Ziggs, unfortunately. Hoping to see him pretty soon, or we'll replace the Ziggs with somebody else. Like, let's say, Misfortune. Let's sell Poppy for 30 gold. Let's go to level 6. And, I was going to give blue buff to Yas right here, but blue buff Yas is actually not that good, you guys. I've tried it before, but it was kind of bad. So I don't know about blue buff Yas. We got sword, bow. Let's grab a chain vest, I think. Or it's gonna be a tear. Huh. What should I grab? Let's grab a large rod. Now we got Karma and Fiddle. Hey. Hey. What's up, Karma? Let's give her a blue buff. And let's drop the Vayne for Gragas. I'm also going to sell Yas now. And bring in Fiddlesticks to the team. This looks pretty good. Now we got blue buff on the Karma. I Also wanted to buy Soraka, but then I can't econ because I don't want to drop anybody else on this team. So we're gonna ignore the Soraka for now and use the Cavs and Karma as effectively as we can from this point on with Cavaliers. Maybe we got Revenants coming up as well. All right, this is so bad. Well, from these radiant items, it's clearly not these four because we have no plans of playing AD. So let's go for the stone plate and give that to the Hecarim. Doing super good right now. You can see that Karma, even though she has really fallen off in this current meta, is possible to work in a comp like this, especially when you got that blue buff good to go. Pick her up and give Karma a chance. We got Draven now and Riven. Let's bring in Draven, drop the Fiddlesticks. Okay. We gotta get some big damage items and tank items. Wait, please tell me it's a double fun. Yes, it's not a double fun. I'm at double spatula. Double fun would be hella OP. I love this for sure. Let's go for the fawn on the Lux. And then I guess we could bring in Riven for Legion bonus. Maybe, yeah, this looks good. We have a lot of Hecarims. Now I got two choices. Oh, this guy's, I don't know. I don't think he's playing Hecarim. He just has a Hecarim too. So I got two choices, right? I can reroll for Heck, or I can just level up and play a different build. Misfortune is contested. Hecarim is not contested, but Misfortune is contested. Okay, we got Sword Giant's Belt. Let's grab the Giant's Belt. Okay, I think I'm gonna roll. Yeah, when you got this kind of start, you got a lot of Heck. Might be good to roll, you guys. Maybe get some brands. Maybe get some brands. Okay, we got a Thresh. Huh, alright. So, team is looking pretty mixed up right now. Maybe it's a brand, maybe it's not. I'm planning to go one more giant spell item for Heck. Third item for Heck, that's why I got a giant spell here. Blue buff brand is kind of no longer good. That's why you don't really see him that much. There's just other comps to play. But could he still work? Possibly. Possibly he could work. We're gonna have to just see what happens in this game. Yeah, two star Gragas, Rel Nautilus. Alright. And not a single Heck. We got a Giant's Belt, Sword, Bow, Large Rod. Kinda want the Veil. Veil's gone. I'm taking a tier. What is wrong with you, boy? Why are you trying to take my tier? Alright. And now we're gonna do a redemption, I believe. I think I'm gonna do a redemption, yeah. Let's go redemption on the Heck. That's a decent tank item. And we're gonna keep rolling. We got Misfortune. So I'm gonna actually use Misfortune. Okay, four Forgotten. Drop the Riven. Blue buff on Misfortune. You know what? No brand. Yeah, I don't trust brand. I definitely don't trust brand. So anyways, this Hecarim is supposed to be as tanky as possible. Oh, he just fell to his death. He's gotta be 3-star this game. He gotta be 3-star if we want a good chance to win. Alright. We got 2-star Thresh. Ivern. Another Karma. Hecarim finally shows up. Okay, you know what? Drop the Kled, drop the Gragas. It's time to do a bit of a swap. Let's go Rel and Ironclad bonus, right? That's what we'll do. Oh, another Thresh. Yo, what up, dude? What's up, dude? Here we go. So, we're 2 Ekrims away and 2 Thresh away from the 3 stars. We have 4 Forgotten, 3 Cavaliers, 2 Ironclad, and 2 Knights for tons of armor now. And Hecarim is going to have to do his best to survive here. It is a Hecarim-focused game. He got to survive that Riven, but he doesn't. Oh my god, 35 health points playing this comp, dude. And we got the Radiant Orb now. It's a Tome. Got another Rel. Let's drop Nautilus for Rel. Nice. That's done, you guys. So, we're going to open this Tome up and see what the bad boy is. Ironclad Emblem? Fosho. Yeah, that was pretty easy. That was a pretty easy one. So anyways, we got 3-star Hecarim back on the team, baby. And just got to hit 1 more Thresh here. 1 more Thresh. Let's go to... yeah, let's roll. Just going to try to 3-star all the ponies. Nice. That's done. Okay, let's give Ironclad Emblem to, I suppose, give it a Thresh. So we got 3 Ironclad for 70 armor now. Drop the Clad. And then the other items, I want to chill a little bit. Next round, we might get an item component. This is a 3-star rat with cannon. Can he beat us? I might hammer the blue buff. I might actually hammer the blue buff. Oh, he wrecked us. Do I hammer the blue buff? Alright, we gotta go level 7. And the reason why is because we're so low. And we gotta put in 4 ironclads. Yep. This is why we gotta do this. And we're gonna just actually roll down. Maybe we can 2-star... some more guys here. And... there we go. There we go. Okay, so... Sejuani. Or is it Draven who gets items? I gotta use these items for sure. Let's go Rabadon. Giant Slayer MF. Yeah, I'll just go Giant Slayer MF. Here we go. So 4 Ironclad anyways. Tons of armor for our guys now. Things are looking better. Hammer the MF. Okay. I was going to hammer the Sedge, but I realized that Rabadon is pretty good on her, especially if she's 3-star. I'm going to hammer the Misfortune. Ooh. Okay, that's pretty good. Oh, that's pretty good. That's more tank items. So, this is a tank game. My items are not really focused on my Misfortune or Draven, even though it would be nice to give them items. But because since this is a Cavalier focus game, we're just trying to maximize our tanks here. Oh my god, dude, the Thresh got... he stole my Thresh 3, but it's okay. He couldn't kill Heck. He couldn't kill Sedge. Alright. So, let's go Wurmog's own Rel. We got another tank item. This Thresh almost one-shotted Aphelios. Yeah, he does a lot of damage. He does a lot of damage. Look at this 4 Ironclad Beast comp right now. This 4 Ironclad Beast comp is so tanky. We barely take any damage. And I don't even need damage items. I only have tank items and I'm winning. Alright, let's put Jax here because there's somebody with a Zephyr. We don't want Hecarim or Rel to get Zephyr. Yep. And this guy has Aphelios. He's going to do no damage once again. look, man, when everybody's playing, you know, these attack damage comps nowadays, you just gotta go all tank. I didn't think this was gonna work, but apparently the Cavaliers are amazing. My Thresh doing like half damage to this guy with one hook. Sejuani still alive, Misfortune still alive. Another hook to the face for Aphelios from the 3-star Thresh is just decimating this player. One of you guys said sell the Sej, give the Rabadon to Thresh. I like that idea, but then I missed my chance to get a Sej 3, so that's what I don't like. Like, it's not really... it doesn't seem that great of an idea. We got Viego, we can put him in. Okay, so we got Ionic Spark. Let's give that to Rell. I think we're just gonna go level 8. Not roll down anymore. Sejuani 3 can still come out at level 8. Honestly. So once again, can Jax... okay, this is Jax. Can a Jax kill Hecarim? Can he kill Hecarim? He's actually doing a lot of damage. Yeah, he just killed everybody, look. He's at plus 10,000 damage. Wow. Jax can take down Heck. Holy smokes. Alright, let's go level 8. Jax can take out Sej. Maybe I have to go max caps. Alright. I was thinking about max cav, but I don't think so. This guy's 3-star Lee. I don't know if I should go max cav. I feel like Kled never adds enough value. That's why I don't play max cav. Oh wow. Ranger Jax, bro. Alright. He beat us. Oh wait. Can he kill Rell? Oh, he beat me. Huh. Misfortune is doing damage. See, I told you she comes out. Okay. I am justified, and I am armed. Nice. This guy I should beat. So we got 2-star Volibear, this is huge. And we also have 3-star Sej, so this is also huge. Right? 13 magic damage. Ooh, that's huge. Tristana, I'll beat this. I'll beat Triss. I stole his cannon. That's huge. So the Rats player goes down to me 100%. Bully Bear is still alive. And we got the win. There we go. The next item I will take. Triple Redemption. Triple Redemption. Okay. Triple Redemption. Just try it. We got Nautilus. 2-star Nautilus now, okay. Alright, let's go Redemption on Rell. Alright, let's try this. Triple Redemption. Yeah, this is gonna be Triple Redemption. Cavaliers. Alright, I lost to this Jax guy last time. Yeah, we're lacking damage. That is a problem. Lacking damage. But... it's okay. Oh, my Viego got his Jax. My Viego got his Jax. He didn't die yet, but he's gonna die. I think I won. Sick. He's out, yo. He's out. Yo, it's a first. It's a first. It's a first. He couldn't be my ghost either. Alright, let's move Viego here. Because Felius right there. Okay. Oh, my Viego's on his rail. That's okay. Just take his rail. Take his rail. This guy can't kill my guys quick enough. He has a 3-star lead, but... Dude, tank meta, you guys. Play Cavaliers, man. This comp is still good. Yeah. Nobody's playing this comp? Guess who plays it? The guy who decides to play it with a new brain, with a new mind. You know, I'm here to counter the meta. This is the anti-meta Cavalier Ironclad build. Try it out, you guys. It's definitely a first place comp. Thanks for watching.